My name is Lizette. I am 33 years old and I have three kids.
What do you do for work?
I don't work. I stay home and take care of my house and my family. However, I did used to be a seamstress and I was very good at it and then lost my job. I cook and I clean and I take care of my kids and my husband.
What do you think of the aristocracy?
I think that they're very wasteful, but I don't know much about it, I guess. My husband knows more than I do.
What about the working class women?
I think that their place is in the home and not in the factory, and it's wrong for them to be in a working environment.
How do you feel about the bread riots?
I don't know much. I know that my kids are scared, my husband is worried, but I don't know much else.
Do you think the bread prices are too high?
I think it's becoming harder to feed my family.
My name is Olivier, and I'm a factory worker, formerly a laundress.
All right.
What do you do in your daily life?
I wake up really, really early and walk to the factory I work at for over 12 hours a day. And then afterwards, I will do my best. I sometimes teach myself to read, but sometimes I need to go right to bed because I don't get enough sleep anymore.
Right. What do you think of housewives?
Sometimes I envy the fact that they don't have to pay for everything themselves, but I don't think that it's right to be controlled by a man, and I don't think they have enough freedom. I at least have the freedom to decide if I learn or not.
How about the aristocracy? What are your feelings on that?
I think they waste money, and there are so many people out there who don't have enough money, like me. I don't have enough money to buy bread anymore. The bread prices are too high. I'm working hours and hours a day. It's not as bad as when I was a laundress, when I used to have to work in a huge room of women and we'd have to take our shirts off and everyone would laugh and stare at us because it was too hot, but it's still impossible, even with the highest paying job, to eat. And the aristocracy is just wasting money.
What do you think the people should do?
I think the people should educate themselves, and we need to fight for our freedom to live and our freedom to be.
Please tell us about yourself.
So my name is Belle, and I'm a member of the aristocracy. So we are pretty awesome, and I like to have parties, and I party a lot.
Where do you work?
I don't work. I don't have to work because I have other people to do my work for me, and my husband is rich, so it doesn't matter.
What do you do all day then?
I organize parties. And I go to parties, and I spend a lot of time getting ready in the morning.
What do you think about your servants?
My servants? I mean, they're there to work for me, and they're pretty awesome, because they do everything for me.
What about the working class in factories?
I mean, I don't know, like, they work, and that sounds terrible. So, it's too bad for them, I guess.
And do you have any kids?
I do. I think they're 3 and 7. I let my nursemaid take care of them. And I have one boy and one girl. And the boy is named Pierre, and the girl is named Lucille.
What about housewives? How do you feel about people who take care of their own kids?
I mean, it sounds really hard. I don't know why they would have to do that. They think they should just hire their own nursemaids.
What do you think about the bread riots and other revolutions that have been going on?
I mean, I understand that the bread prices are high, but I think the workers should just work harder and earn more money.
How do you feel about your king? I mean, there's a lot of people that are calling estates and stuff, and they think that the king needs less power. What do you think?
I mean, the king is my king, and so I support him no matter what.
My name is Josette, and I was born into the nobility.
What do you do for work?
I don't do much in the way of work. I inherited all of the money that I have now, but I do write quite a few pamphlets and papers.
What does your daily life include?
Mostly going to society parties, where I try to tell my fellow noble women and other aristocrats the beauty and power that you gain when you have the proper education. And I also go to workhouses and tell them about the glories of education and all that women can accomplish.
What do you think of the lower class?
I think that they are not given the opportunity that they need to accomplish all that they can, and that they are sorely lacking in education.
And what about the aristocracy?
I think that they're a travesty and they do nothing but sit and talk about inconsequential things and waste all of their time flitting from one party to the next.
Then why do you go to their parties?
I'm not quite sure. I think that it's mostly so that I can try and share my views with them and get them to take the power that they have and do something with it.
Do you think the revolution will allow you to get your voice out there and give you more rights?
I think that it will. I feel that the strongest group within the revolution are the women, such as myself.
I am Marie Antoinette, daughter of Maria Theresa of Austria, and married to King Louis XVI. I married Louis to produce an heir to the French throne and to bring peace between our countries. The Parisian people have been slandering my name and besmirching my honor.
We're going to kill the queen!
Workhouses to help educate the masses, and instead she's at some party with two random strangers.
Are you ready to march to Versailles?
Well, but whatever it takes to feed my family.
I'm going to kill the queen. The high bread prices are her fault. I need food.
I suppose that's true. Don't you think it's a little drastic?
It's very drastic, but this is the revolution, and I need to eat. And she is wasting all of our money. She lost. Did you hear about the necklace she lost?
What?
Worth so much money. We could have eaten for the rest of our lives and then some.
Let's get her.
Hi, how are you today?
Good, how are you?
I'm really excited to talk about Napoleon with you.
Oh, please, please don't talk about Napoleon.
You don't support Napoleon?
No, not at all. He took away all our rights.
Well, I didn't have any rights before, and I don't have any rights now, but I have a safe job in the government brothels.
No, all that he did was make you a piece of meat to buy. Women had plenty of rights before.
Like what?
Well, we had the right to inherit, we had the right to claim our illegitimate children, and we had the right to get divorced.
First of all, I do not appreciate the look you just gave me. Second of all, my family has no money. Where am I going to find a man? My life is exactly the same as it was before, except now I have a safer job in the government.
I would love to be able to help all of the other women, but I don't have time or the money to worry about Napoleon's reforms.
Olivier has no womanly pride.
Since Napoleon came into power.
Well, I got pregnant again. This is my sixth child. But I haven't really noticed that much change. My husband doesn't like Napoleon, so I don't like him either.
So did you play any role in the revolution pre-Napoleon?
Well, I took part in a bread march one time, but it wasn't really for me. There's so much violence. I like it much better at my home with my husband.
So, how have you noticed the changes in other women's lives?
I don't really know. My husband hasn't said anything.
How has your life changed since Napoleon came into power?
Well, I stopped working at my factory job, and I got a job in one of the government-owned brothels in Paris because he's made so many of them, and now I have a safe government job, and I no longer have to work as hard for enough money to live without a man.
How do you stay childless in your job?
Well, I'm not religious, so I am able to use sheepskin condoms and the pulling out method.
How do you feel about other women?
Well, I would love to be able to help as much as my friends do, but I don't have time to worry about anyone else. I hear there's been lots of rights changes, but they don't affect me due to my line of work. A lot of my coworkers haven't been affected either.
So how has your life changed since Napoleon came into power?
Well, when the French Revolution happened, we were chased out of France, out of Paris, and we had to leave. But when Napoleon came into power, we were allowed back into the country.
And did you take any active role in revolutionary or counter-revolutionary activities?
No, I mean, we were just scared for our lives. We left as soon as we could.
And how do you feel Napoleon's reforms have changed the lives of women?
Honestly, I don't know. I have my parties back, and I plan parties every night, so my life isn't any different.
So how has your life changed since Napoleon came into power?
Well, I feel that Napoleon has really taken away the voice that I had in 1788, and I'm not very happy about it.
What has changed about your voice?
Well, he's just taken away so many of the rights that we worked so hard for.
Do you think your future is going to be negatively affected by this?
Oh, definitely. I think that the whole country's future has been negatively affected.
So you think it's bad for all women?
Most definitely. I think that women have lost all self-respect that they earned during the revolution.
Do you think that women will ever be able to voice their opinions again?
Not for a long time. We took a huge step backwards when Napoleon came into power.
Secret Marriage, a new reality show about the lives of two Frenchmen as they try and hide their marriages from their wives while fighting during the revolution. It's action, drama, and lots of love.
They are. They're so weak. They should not be fighting in the revolution. Yeah. But you're strong.
Well,
that's why I hired you.
He's been out partying and, like, maybe he's working or something.